Hello my friends, this is Sudipto from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my fourth video on Kubernetes series. Today I'm going to talk about different probes through which you can check your pod health in Kubernetes. So without any further delay, let's jump in. The first probe that I'll be talking today is called liveness probe. So when you create a pod in Kubernetes, you want to make sure that your pod is healthy and running. So this liveness probe is going to help you by checking the pod health every few seconds, which you can configure in the YAML file. And that is what I'm going to show you very shortly. So let's go and jump into the code right now. As you can see, this is a YAML file for my liveness probe. The important thing that you need to remember is that this is the section where I'm configuring the liveness probe. What this probe is doing, this probe will start after an initial delay, which is 10 seconds, and this probe will keep on running every 5 seconds. So the important thing that you need to understand, it will run at 10 seconds and it will keep on running or keep on checking the health of the pod every 5 seconds. And the question is, how it's going to check whether my pod is healthy or not? For example, in this one, every 5 seconds, this pod is going to go to this folder like TMP and find out if there is a file called healthy. If the file is there, then you know it will consider my pod is healthy and it's running. But if the file is not there, what it will do, it will consider my pod is not healthy, so it's going to restart the pod. Now the thing that what you need to understand here, when the pod is getting created, I'm going to create this file, then I am telling go for a sleep for 30 seconds and after 30 seconds delete the file and then go for another 600 second sleep. So first time when this liveness probe will run, it will find out, okay, there is a file healthy under the folder TMP. So it will consider my pod is healthy. But after 30 seconds, when I'm telling go ahead and delete the file, probe will find out that there is no file and it will consider that the pod is not doing well. So it's going to restart the pod. So let's go ahead and execute this code and create a pod with this YAML file. And let's see how liveness probe can help us to find out. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to create the pod with this file. So my pod is ready and this time I am going to execute this command. It's telling my pod is running. So I am going to describe the pod and see what is going on. So describe pod and followed by pod name. This is important. You can see here that it was successfully able to pull the image and created the container and the pod is running fine. So let's give it some time and then execute the same command again. Yes, now here you can see that liveness probe realized that there is no file TMP healthy because we configured in our YAML file that after 30 seconds go and delete the file. So now after 30 seconds when my liveness probe ran, there is no file and that's why probe considered this pod is not doing well or this container is not doing well. So go ahead and restart the pod. So let's execute the same command again. As you can see here, liveness probe failed because there is no file and what it's doing, it's actually restarting the container. So this is what the liveness probe is will going to help you. It's going to check your pod health every few seconds, which you can configure in the YAML file. And if it fails, it's going to restart the container. Okay, let's talk about another probe, which is called the readiness probe. So far, we know that liveness probe can help us to understand whether my container is healthy and running. But what about how do I find out that whether my container has really started or not and it is ready to start new traffic or not? The answer to that is a readiness probe. So readiness probe can help us to find out whether my container is ready to start accepting new traffic. So let's see in the code how we can configure the readiness probe. As you can see, this is the configuration or YAML file for the readiness probe. Here I have configured the readiness probe. What it will do, it will start after 10 seconds, which is mentioned in the initial delay section, and it will keep on checking every 5 seconds. What it will do, it will go to the temp folder and find out if there is a file called healthy. If the file is present, then it will consider that this container is healthy. If the file is not present there, then this probe will consider this container is not healthy. The important thing that you need to understand, in case of liveness probe, if the probe considers the container is not healthy, it's going to restart that. But readiness probe is not going to do that. It's just going to see if the container is healthy or not. If it is not healthy, it's not going to take any action. So let's go and check that in action. So I'm going to create a pod with this readiness probe UML file, and my pod is ready. So let's go ahead and describe this pod. As you can see here, so far everything looks good. So let's give it a few seconds and execute the same command again. As you can see, this time the readiness probe failed because there is no file, because as part of the execution, I have told initially create the file, but after a few seconds, go and delete the file. So now the file is not present, and that's why you can see that the readiness probe failed. But unlike the previous time where we saw that liveness probe was able to restart that, readiness probe will not do that. So to prove that, let's execute the same thing again. And as you can see here, the probe is in a failed state. So that's the difference that you need to understand. Liveness probe is going to restart in case of there is any failure in the container, whereas readiness probe is not going to do that. It's just going to mention that, okay, there is a problem with your container. You go and figure it out. Okay, let's talk about the next probe, which is called the startup probe. Startup probe is similar to the readiness probe, but difference is that readiness probe is not going to restart the container. Startup probe is going to restart the container. So let's see an example. As you can see in the screen, I have this startup probe here in my EML file. The thing that you need to understand here in this section, startup probe, you can see there's two parameters. One is period seconds, one is failure threshold. What does it mean is that this startup probe is going to check for this file, etc, file name Sudipta under the folder etc, after every 10 seconds for 5 times. So first it will check after 10 seconds. Then it will wait for another 10 seconds and going to check again. This way it will continue to check for 5 times. If within this 50 seconds this file is not present here, then startup probe will consider that this container is having some problem and is going to go and restart the container. Like the previous one, readiness probe was not going to restart the container, but startup probe is going to restart the container. So let's go and execute this and create a pod with startup probe configured. So my pod is ready. So let's describe. As you can see, so far everything looks good. Let's execute the same command again, clear the console, and so it failed. There is no file Sudipta. It will fail 5 times. It's already 2 times, 4 times failed. It failed for 5 times, and this is the time when it's killing and it's going to restart the container. So that's the difference. As I was telling before, startup probe is going to restart the container, whereas readiness probe is not going to restart your container. Now the question that might be coming to your mind is like, how can I take full advantage from all this probe, right? Can I combine them together? And the answer is absolutely yes, and that is what you should do. You should combine this probe to take full advantage of that. So let's check, you know, how I have configured liveness probe and startup probe in one single YAML file. As you can see here, this is an YAML file. Everything looks very similar, but the thing that we need to notice is here, I have configured liveness probe and the startup probe both. First, let's understand like what this probe is doing. As part of initiation of the container, what I'm telling, let's go for a sleep for 15 seconds. After that, create a file called healthy inside the folder TMP. Then go for another 30 seconds of sleep and then delete the file. And finally go for another sleep of 600 seconds. Now here is a liveness probe and here is a startup probe. Let's first concentrate on the startup probe. What the startup probe is doing is going to check for the file healthy inside the temp folder. It's going to start after a delay of 10 seconds and it's going to check for 2 times. If within these 2 times it will not find the file healthy, then it will consider this container is having a problem and going to restart. So first time when it will check after 10 seconds, there is no file because it's still sleeping. It will sleep for 15 seconds. Then next time when it will check again, within that time frame, there as part of my initiation code, the file will be created. So startup probe will find out that, okay, first time I was not able to find the file, but second time when I ran, I saw like there was a file. So far for startup prop, everything looks good. The moment it looks good, it will hand over the control to the liveness prop. Now, what liveness prop is doing, it's going to keep on checking the container. And it will wait for 10 seconds and then every after 5 seconds is going to check for the container. So after a few seconds, when this sleep 30 is done, it's going to remove the file. And this is the point where liveness probe will find out, okay, there is no file. So there is some problem with the container. So why don't I go and restart the container? So let's go and execute that. So I'm going to create my pod with this YAML file. My pod is ready. So let's go and describe the pod. As you can see, everything looks very good so far. So let's wait for a few minutes and execute that again. Okay, I can see my startup prop failed. As you can see here, after my startup prop failed one time, next failure is coming from the liveness prop. It's not coming from the startup prop because when the startup prop ran for the second time, the file was already there. So startup prop was successful and it handed over the control to the liveness prop. And liveness prop saw that after some time, the file was deleted. So liveness prop failed. When the liveness prop will fail, it will go and restart the container. So let's see that whether it's doing that. And as you can see, that container is failed and liveness prop is going to restart the container. So, you know, what I was trying to tell you is that these are the three props which are very powerful, which can give you a lot of insight what is going on inside your container. If your container is really healthy, if your container is ready to start accepting traffic, and when you create your YAML file, you can create a YAML file with all these probes inside to take most benefit out of that. So I hope this video is helpful. Please hit the like icon, share, and also please subscribe to my channel to get update about all my upcoming videos. Till then, thank you. Bye bye.